Si hay low, ya tú sabes, no hay más nada.
La nueva generación,
Mr. Worldwide,
a pura fiesta.
Baila, dale, baila. Red One.
Let me introduce you to my party people in the club.
Ya tú sabes, que Armando no barata, que esa loca sale. Las cosas que yo hago no tienen precio, pero oye, vale. Dame un poquito de tequila y yo te corto la gabe. ¿Tú me entiendes? Perfecto, dale. Muñequita, bombosita, mira que tú estás rica.
Latinos were actually the majority of the influence. The music represents Latino culture. They rap about their way of life, the good, the bad, and the ugly.
That's cool.
As population of Mexican Americans grew in places like California, Texas, and Arizona, children in the communities began looking for a new kind of sound.
The youth in these streets, with all their distinct cultures, used hip-hop to speak their feelings and helped hip-hop Latinos spread across America. Historians say it was a product of post-civil rights era. This combines with the rap sounds with lyrics from the barrios, some of which include Spanglish.
Kid Frost's song La Raza begins the genre, according to historians, along with Los Racas.
Those are two young Panamanian artists who use hip-hop music to search for a better situation. Their name Raca comes from a shortened Panamanian word, Rakataka, trying to influence change. People use the word Raca to negatively refer to people from the hood, and they try to make it a positive thing. Los Racas believe that Panama is becoming more corrupt and violent. They want to influence their youth to stop taking the wrong path and follow Los Racas and follow their dreams and become successful.
Hey, Drizzen!
Even though Los Racas left Panama, they're admired because they keep in touch with their roots and try to help their people. Kids are motivated and inspired by all Latino artists, encouraging them to never give up on their talent or goals to create good change. They describe their music as organic and speaking what they feel.